I did an opening scream on Mr. Wendal, which is probably the most notable. The scream to me was just my way of making sure the record wasn't too pop. I wasn't going for pop, but Steely Dan and their that particular groove of theirs sort of lends itself to pop music. And so I just love the groove. But when I listened to it without the scream, I felt like it was just too palatable and too safe. And I wanted to just dirty it up a little bit in a sense. And I liked a lot of ska bands like Fishbone and punk rock bands and Dead Kennedys and stuff like that. I just wanted to make sure that it wasn't too clean. And so yeah, the scream was just sort of a rebellious intro, sort of get some of the fake fans out of the way and, you know, so, that kind of thing. I loved De La's I Know You Better song, and they sampled Steely Dan, and I love Steely Dan, that groove. I wasn't very familiar with their catalog, but I got familiar, and absolutely adored that groove. And I wanted to make something that was in that light, that was in that vein. So yeah, the keys and all that stuff I programmed myself. So I didn't sample any Steely on that, but definitely inspired by Steely.
Here, have a dollar. In fact, no, brother man, here, have two. $2 means a snack for me, but it means a big deal to you. Be strong, serve God only. Know that if you do, beautiful heaven awaits. Asked to pull my rope for the first time. I saw a man with no clothes, no money, no plate, Mr. Wendell. That's his name. No one ever knew his name, cause he's a no one. Never thought twice about spending on an old bum until I had the chance to really get to know one. Now that I know him, to give him money isn't charity. He gives me some knowledge, I buy him some shoes. And to think blacks spend all their money on big colleges, still most of y'all come out confused. Go ahead, Mr. Wendell.
You know, Mr. Wendell was very much from real life. Me and Headliner would record at this studio in Atlanta, and homeless people would come to the studio all the time because they used to hang out in the area. And we would invite them in. We'd have a talk with them. We'd chat with them. And they were always a lot of them were the most insightful people. They really had an understanding of humanity more than a lot of us who have all the sort of normal things of society have. So like they understood the real humanity, and we were trapped in the niceties of society. And so they had a lot of wisdom, a lot of deep truths about who we are as people, who we really are and not who we pretend to be, who we are without masks. So yeah, that whole story was pretty much based on having great conversations with homeless people.
Mr. Wendell has freedom, a free that you and I think is dumb. Free to be without the worries of a quick to diss society, for Mr. Wendell's a bum. His only worries are sickness and an occasional harassment by the police in their chase. Uncivilized, we call him, but I just saw him eat off the food we waste. Civilization, are we really civilized? Yes or no? Who are we to judge when thousands of innocent men could be brutally enslaved or killed over a racist grudge? Mr. Wendell has tried to warn us about our ways, but we don't hear him talk. Is it his fault when we've gone too far? And we got too far, because on him we walk.
There wasn't a particular dude named Mr. Wendell per se. Once we came out with the record, there was a dude that we sort of started calling Mr. Wendell. And he was in our video. And his face is on that single. Well, part of his face is on the single. And we used the same brother in the music video, too. He's pushing a cart. He passed away right after that video came out.
Mr. Wendell, a man, a human in flesh, but not by law. I bid you dignity to stand with pride. Realize that all in all, you stand tall. Go ahead, Mr. Wendell.
On that one, I did a Sly Stone chant that's at the end of a Simple Song, I believe it was, and I did it backwards. Well, and forward and backward, actually. And the drums I used, well, I can't say again. So, yeah, but the main drums I programmed, but like there is a sample drum that's underneath that Headliner was scratching in the record. And yeah, so that was a record, but the rest was like a drum machine. I used to have a HR16 Alesis drum machine back in the day, and I was using that. I back then I had a ASR10 or maybe an Insonic 16, I forget. But bottom line is, yeah, there's just canned sounds from the ASR10 Insonic keyboard. That's me playing, yeah.